In this video, I want to cover vision and strategy, how it relates to Salesforce and your overall revenue engine, and why it's so important to get this right before implementing technology. As I've mentioned in other videos, I've worked with over 1,000 sales, marketing, and service teams in my career and seen many of them in hyper growth mode, on the way to 50 million, 100 million or more in revenue. I also worked internally at Salesforce as they grew from 5 billion in revenue to 10 billion in just 3 years, and have worked closely with them as a consultant as they've grown well past $20 billion since. One thing Salesforce and these top performing companies all have in common is really clear alignment between their vision and strategy and their process and technology. Salesforce's founder and CEO Mark Benioff has made his V2MOM methodology famous. The framework starts at the very top with the CEO outlining his vision, values, methodologies, obstacles, and metrics for the year, and then asking his direct reports to do the same. This rolls all the way down the organization to every single employee and helps align efforts across the entire organization. If you know the vision and strategy for your company and your leadership team, it's a lot easier to build a revenue engine that helps you execute that strategy and realize that vision. And yet, your average company does not do this. It requires a lot of thought, effort, and time from the leadership team, and your average executive or revenue leader would prefer to just delegate this to someone else, hoping they can just figure out the process and technology with little or no support and guidance. As this rolls down the organization to the sales, marketing, and service process and technology, a lot can be lost in translation. So what's the solution? It's actually not that complicated. Executives and leaders simply need to avail themselves to the team building and managing the revenue engine and share the vision and strategy with them so they can align with it. Let me share how you can do this. Let's start with vision. Where is the company headed in the next 12, 24, 36 months? What about longer term, 5 to 10 years? Who are we trying to serve and what problems are we solving for them? How will that change? How will the product or service change as time goes on? And how will the team change and grow over time? What investments does the company have planned, such as launching a new product or going into a new market? This stuff is usually pretty easy for leaders to articulate, but so often gets overlooked. If we're trying to build the best revenue engine possible, it helps a lot to know the direction we're trying to head. Once we have the vision laid out, what's our strategy to achieve it? Sales Hacker has a great article on mapping out your strategy in 7 steps. I'm gonna share it here and condense it to 6 steps and focus on what's most relevant for building your sales, marketing, and service process and technology. Everything starts with your target market and your product or service, specifically your ideal customer profile and the problems you're trying to solve for them and how you solve them. Without a clear definition of your ideal customer profile and target market, it's very difficult to do something as simple as managing your customer and prospect data in your CRM. How do we determine the data we need to create good sales and marketing target lists if we don't have a clear understanding of our ideal customer? How do we build a sales, marketing, and service process that meets the needs of these customers if we don't have a clear understanding of what they are? And how do we identify the best way to get in front of our customers if we're not clear on our brand and positioning? I'll skip over pricing strategy as it has a little less impact on process and technology, but it's obviously a critical element. The go-to-market strategy is obviously the meat of what's relevant to your revenue engine. We need to go where our customers are, and we need to define the sales and marketing channels we'll use to reach out to our ideal customer and the step-by-step process to attract them, close them, serve them, retain them, and grow them. I covered the process in another video, but obviously that can only be mapped out on the foundation of a clear vision and strategy. And finally, we have metrics. If your vision is to grow revenue by X percentage by doing A, B, and C, we need to identify the leading and lagging indicators, or key performance indicators, that can help us understand if we're on track to realize that vision. Then and only then can we design a step-by-step, channel-by-channel process, as I described in the other video, to realize this vision. I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like to learn more, reach out to me directly to set up a meeting and/or check out some of our other videos on the website, LinkedIn, or YouTube.